Cartoonito Tales, Billy Goat's Gruff. It's a rainy old day. Billy and his little sisters, Millie and Lilly, are at their Nana's house. They love visiting her. She's very kind and sweet. But she doesn't have any toys for them to play with. "I know," says Billy. "Let's play I Spy." Even though Lilly is the littlest, she always likes to go first.
"My go," she says. "I spy with my little eye something beginning with G."
"Goats," says Millie. Billy has to stop his sisters from playing with Nana's ornaments.
"They may look like little toy goats, but they're very delicate," he says. "Nana would be very upset if they were to get broken."
Lilly just can't believe Nana doesn't have any toys. What does she do for fun? So she starts to search the living room high and low. Billy and Millie think she's a little silly, but they soon join in, hoping to find an adventure along the way. Lilly finds a little mouse hole. She reaches in to see if there are any toys hidden inside. And as she does, something very curious happens. The little mouse hole begins to grow bigger and bigger until there is just enough room to crawl through to the other side. Who could ever have imagined that on the other side of Nana's very ordinary living room there would be a lush green meadow dotted with daisies? A little wooden bridge crosses the clear blue stream that runs through it. On the other side, a party has been laid out with bunting and balloons and a delicious feast of party food. Billy spots the dress-ups hanging from a tree.
"It must be a fancy dress party," he says.
So they put on the swishy, swishy tails. They put on the pointy, pointy horns and goatee beards. Then, last but not least, they put on their little hooves that go trip-trap, trip-trap. Now they look just like little goats. A mean old troll watches them from the other side of the stream. He rubs his hands together with glee. His plan is working.
"This is my bridge," he says. "No one can cross without getting past me."
Lilly, the littlest goat, has an idea.
"If I ask the troll very nicely, making sure to say please, he will certainly let me cross the bridge," she thinks.
Lilly trip-trap, trip-traps onto the bridge.
"Who dares to cross my bridge?" says the troll.
"It is I, Lilly," says the littlest goat. "Please may I cross the bridge to get to the other side?"
"Oh, silly Lilly, I will gobble you up."
But Lilly is a very fast runner. She scampers away as fast as she can. Millie has been thinking very hard, and at last she has an idea.
"If I lay these stones across the stream, then I can hop over to the other side," she thinks.
She drops a stone into the stream with a splash. The troll waits until Millie's back is turned. Then he picks up the stone and hides it under his bridge. Millie is quite cross when she sees what he has done.
"That That was my stone, she says.
But the troll just laughs. There is only one way to cross the stream, and that is over my bridge, he says. Poor Millie doesn't know what to do.
The troll watches Billy build a little raft out of twigs and sticks and leaves. Billy works very hard, and soon enough, the raft is finished. He pushes it into the stream. It floats. But the troll jumps into the water and makes big rolling waves.
The little raft gets washed away.
There is only one way to cross the stream, and that is over my bridge, says the troll.
Poor Billy doesn't know what to do.
The three little goats are just about ready to give up. But then Billy has an idea. They huddle together and he whispers his plan. Lilly trip-trap, trip-traps onto the bridge.
Who dares to cross my bridge? Says the troll.
It is I, Lilly,
says the littlest goat.
Oh, silly Lilly, says the troll. I will gobble you up.
Don't eat me, says brave Lilly. I won't fill you up. My sister is coming, and she's much bigger than me. Why don't you wait for her?
The troll certainly has room in his tummy for an even bigger goat, so he lets Lilly cross over to the other side. Millie trip-trap, trip-traps onto the bridge.
Who dares to cross my bridge? Says the troll.
It is I, Millie,
says the middle-sized goat.
Oh, silly Millie, says the troll. I will gobble you up.
Don't eat me, says Millie. My brother is coming, and he's much bigger than me. Why don't you wait for him?
It must be my lucky day,
thinks the troll. So he lets Millie cross over to the other side. Then Billy trip-trap, trip-traps onto the bridge.
Who dares to cross my bridge? Says the troll.
It is I, Billy,
says the biggest goat.
Oh, silly Billy, says the troll as he climbs onto the bridge. I will gobble you up.
Don't eat me, says Billy.
I'm very hungry and I can't wait no longer. I will gobble you up.
But just as he opens his terrible jaws, Millie and Lilly charge up behind him. They give him such a fright, he wobbles and falls right into the stream.
The three little goats can't help but giggle as the troll gets washed away.
They are so excited. The party food looks delicious. They tuck straight in. The troll swam all the way back to the bridge. He looks very sad indeed. The little goats feel very sorry for him.
If you promise not to eat us, you can come and join our party, says Lilly.
The troll promises not to eat them. So Lilly lets him join in. The troll has never tasted party food before. He tries a sticky bun.
This party food is delicious, he says. It tastes much better than goat. From now on, I'll never eat another goat ever again.
The three little goats are so happy. Of course, it just wouldn't be a party without dancing. The three little goats just love to dance. And the troll does too.
It seems like no time at all before Billy, Millie and Lily have to go home. They give their dress-ups back to the troll. Then they wave goodbye before crawling through the little mouse hole. Billy, Millie and Lily are back at their Nana's house. They miss their new friend and this makes them feel a little sad. But what's this on the mantelpiece? Why, it's three little toy goats! Now they can play happily all afternoon at Nana's house.